So last night, if you don't know, Emma Beeney and Tiffany Paff were the guest speakers at the Oxford Street Elementary graduation. We talk a lot as teachers, as administrators, about taking risks. So I decided I'm going to take a risk today and just grab my canned speech and just go off with some notes. We encourage you to take risks, to try different things. As Tiffany nicely said, and I'm paraphrasing, take a look beyond what is right in front of you. It's a great message. But at the end of it, I was really touched by what Emma Beeney said, and I think it really encapsulates all we try to do, and I hope everybody here believes this. Emma was talking to the eighth graders, and she was talking about taking chances, doing different things when you're in high school. I'm going to try to quote almost exactly, but I'll probably be paraphrasing. She said, join the swim team, even if you've never swam. Join the band if you've never played an instrument. Try to sing if you've never been to chorus. Try going into the play if you've never acted. And she said, and I think this really sums up what we try to instill in our students. In Belvidere, nothing is impossible. And I love that line. I was moved. I was inspired. It made me want to be a better person, a better administrator, to work with the teachers to really raise the expectations in what we give to our students. So I say, take that with you. Not only in Belvidere is nothing impossible, in life nothing is impossible if you put your mind to it. So please, keep that with you. Live your dreams, dream big. Parents, friends, and family, I thank you for the dedication you've given. You've allowed us to work with your students, for most of us, for upwards of 13 years, for almost 8 hours a day. Some of these students more than 8 hours a day, and we appreciate that. To our teachers, you look before you and you see a great product. Your hard work, their hard work. We all work together, and this is what we have. So I thank everyone. I thank you, ladies, for allowing me to kind of paraphrase your words, and I wish everyone the best of luck. Thank you. And now I introduce Mr. McInerney.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Karuba. On behalf of the Belvidere Board of Education, congratulations to the class of 2019. Congratulations to your parents, your grandparents, family, and friends. Also, a heartfelt note of appreciation for the board to our administrators, our teachers, our child study team, nurses, support staff. They really bring it every day, and they really have helped provide the type of quality education that you've received here at Belvidere. So could we get a quick acknowledgement for our staff here at Belvidere? Thank you. There's a part, I talked about this last year and it really resonated with me. So there's a part of Judaism that talks about the Tikkun Olam, which basically talks about how the world is broken into a lot of little pieces and how it's each of our responsibilities to kind of help put things back together. And I kind of think right now, this is really a time for healing. It's time for mending, and perhaps most importantly, a time for helping. And one of the hallmarks I really feel about Belvidere and Belvidere students is how kind you all are, how supportive you are to each other. And it might be part of being a small school, which I think actually is, in many respects, a big strength here at Belvidere. Your sincere desire to help others shines all the time, and I hear stories about helping and in a really sincere way, and in a way that doesn't really draw attention to yourself, but more in the way that you just have this desire to help and be kind. And I think now more than ever, that's something we really need. We're really encouraged by your sense of optimism, your determination. Excuse me, sorry. Your sense of optimism, your positive energy, your tolerance and acceptance of others, your willingness to embrace diversity. So as you go forward, be true to your convictions, be respectful and command respect and accept nothing less. And don't worry about making a mistake or two along the way, we all have. And it's an opportunity also to learn. So our generation didn't always get it right also. On behalf of the Board of Education, we wish you the very best, and we just wish to congratulate you and enjoy tonight's event. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. McInerney. Mr. Karuba. I'm Ed Lazara, the principal of the high school. What a day. What a great day today. Good evening, Mr. Karuba, members of the Board of Education, local dignitaries, invited guests, staff, family, friends, and students. It is with great honor and pleasure that I welcome you to our commencement exercises for the class of 2019. I would also like to welcome the thousands of viewers joining us from all over the world on our live webcast, including my in-laws from Mount Pleasant, South Carolina. I would also like to thank everyone for their assistance in preparing for our ceremony. A few to mention would be Mrs. Iorio, Ms. Merrick, Mr. Zetterstrom, Mr. AP, Mr. Barrack, Mr. Wildermuth, Ms. McKinney, and many others. I was speaking with my wife this week and she asked me, what exactly is a cedar? And I asked her, why are you asking me this? She said, well, do you know what Belvidere stands for? Then I said, don't answer my question with a question. What is this about? She said, well, what is a cedar? What does that stand for? So I broke out into our four core values and I said, we stand for tradition, community, academics, and excellence. And I was pretty proud of myself with that answer. And she said, no. Do you know what the word Belvidere means? Where it was derived from? She then told me that the word Belvidere is derived from the Italian language. Bel meaning beautiful, and vedere meaning view. So Belvidere means the place having a beautiful view. Then she said, so I guess it would be like, sit here in the county seat, and you will have a beautiful view. And I did confirm this with my mother. She came to this country from Italy when she was 10 years old and speaks Italian. And she told me the correct pronunciation would be Bella Vedere. My wife then said that she was reading that you can see all the way to Philly on a clear day. I said, well, I don't know about that, but what I do know is if you sit in the county seat, not only will you have a beautiful view, but you will also get an excellent education. Belvidere's academics and our list of colleges and universities are impressive. We have students throughout the country at prestigious institutions of higher learning that include the Air Force Academy, West Point, Princeton, University of Pennsylvania, Lehigh, Lafayette, Gettysburg, Syracuse, Stevens Institute, the College of New Jersey, Rutgers, Penn State, George Washington, and the list goes on. If you want to attend a top institution in our great nation, then sit down in the county seat. She then asked me, do you have any famous people that attended Belvidere? And I said, well, Chris Karabinas went here, and he is a Belvidere celebrity. He was our former athletic director and our current Oxford Street principal, and he bleeds scarlet and white so much that he gets misty-eyed every graduation speech I've ever given. Mr. Karabinas, where are you, Mr. Karabinas? We are Belvidere, Mr. Karabinas. And how great is our school and our traditions? This is the 127th graduating class, 127 years of Belvidere graduates. If you want to attend the school with great tradition, then sit down in the county seat. How great is our community? We have an excellent community of caring people, fantastic teachers, respectful students. If you want to live in a great community, then sit down in the county seat. How great are the people and the students? If you want to surround yourself with great people and great students, and you want to develop long-lasting relationships, then sit down in the county seat. And how great is our spirit? You should see our homecoming pep rally and be here for Spirit Week. If you want to go to a school with great spirit and great pride, then sit down at the county seat. I've been in many other schools in my career, and you'll be hard-pressed to find a culture and climate as supportive as ours here at BHS. This year, we asked our teachers the same question. What is a county cedar? And their responses consisted of, a county cedar is family, a county cedar is tradition, a county cedar is community, and a county cedar is pride. And I love the opportunity to speak here at graduation to offer some final words of advice and tell everyone who will listen how great Belvidere is. seniors. Sorry about that. Seniors, if your parents and adults in your life are anything like me, they will say to their children, you don't know how good you have it. You think you have all the answers. And I used to walk to school uphill both ways. We didn't have cell phones, we didn't have internet, and so on and so forth, and blah, blah, blah. Those messages just bring you down, especially on graduation day. And I know what you're thinking. What do your parents really know anyway? What have they really done or experienced in their lives? You'll be surprised to learn how smart your parents have gotten at the end of your 4 years of college, and you begin trying to make it on your own. So I won't tell you those things, but I will tell you that there is nobody in this world that loves you, roots for you, and wants you to succeed more than your mom, your dad, and the rest of your family. So when they take the time to have those heart-to-heart talks with you, they do that because they love you. Finally, a quick quote from legendary basketball coach John Wooden. It is what you learn after you know it all that counts. Members of the graduating class of 2019, congratulations. Continue to make us proud. And remember, wherever you go and whatever you do, you can always come back to the county seat, sit down, and enjoy the view. Thank you. At this time, can we have our salutatorian, Jordan Corey, come up to the podium, please?
This thing's playing tricks on me here, so let's see. Okay. Right there. That's yours.
Hello and good evening. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Jordan Corey. 4 short years ago, we were all incoming freshmen, small and inexperienced, and unable to walk on the right side of the hallway. I can still vividly remember what I felt as I started my high school career. I was excited and nervous, ambitious, but very, very afraid. Those first days of high school were not that long ago, but it feels as if a lifetime has transpired between the day I first wandered the halls of Belvidere, getting lost looking for my homeroom, to now as we finally walk to receive our diplomas. High school has been a time of great personal growth for all of us. It is a period of transition where we grow from dependent children to confident and prepared young adults ready to take on the world. This transition would have not been possible without all the wonderful people who have helped us along the way. To all the faculty, family, and friends who have kept us on track and guided us through our journey, thank you. This day is just as much a celebration of the culmination of your guidance as it is our accomplishments. I would personally like to thank my parents for always providing support and encouragement, and my grandfather, who somehow knew what I wanted to pursue before I did. Without you, I would not be able to stand here today. For the past 4 years, me and my classmates have persevered through trials and tribulations of high school. Through both the ups and downs, we have managed to make it here, our 4-year journey coming to an end. Each of us here today have all had different experiences and have grown in different ways, but we have all taken this journey together. While graduation is a time to look forward to all the amazing things in our futures, it can also be a time to reflect on the last chapter of our lives, our successes, our failures, regrets, and fond memories. The next period of our lives, whether it be continuing our education, entering the workforce, or joining the military, offers us a chance to change. Looking back on what we did in high school, it is just as important to recognize our failures as it is to celebrate our successes in order to grow and live with less regrets in the future. Think about the one thing you wish you did in high school. It might be working harder, being more active in the community, or socializing more. It is important that we can recognize these and apply them to our lives moving forward. It is never too late to try and learn something new, and graduation gives us the perfect fresh start. This time of change is the perfect opportunity to reinvent ourselves, apply yourself to your schooling, join a club, or become dedicated to a career. The past 4 years have taught all of us so much about others, the world around us, and most importantly, ourselves, but it will only matter if we put this knowledge to use. It is time to accomplish what we've always dreamed of and live our best lives. The last piece of advice I will give this class is this. Do not live your life with any regrets. Opportunities are too rare to let them pass by, so it is imperative that you capitalize on every open door in front of you. The worst feeling is to look back on your life and wonder how it would have been if you had not let opportunities pass you by. Do not be afraid to push yourself harder and test your limits, because the outcome of your hard work will be worth it. Congratulations to the class of 2019. We have persevered through high school, and now it is time to not only persevere, but thrive as we continue our journey through life. The next few years may take us on different paths, but never forget your roots or the lessons you learned here. It is a pleasure to grow beside you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Jordan. And at this time, I would like to call up Desley Norcross, our valedictorian.
Greetings, faculty, family, and friends. It is an honor to be here as I give the imparting words to the class of 2019. My fellow graduates, it is incredible to think that we have spent 4 years at Belvidere High School to make it here today. It is also important to recognize that we are not the same people who entered freshman year. We have all been influenced by the people we meet and the experiences we accumulate, which we will take with us as we move forward into the next stage. I personally will fondly remember donut parties with Mrs. Poyer, the intense psychology discussions with Mr. Phillips, and three sister farming from Mr. Demarest, who claimed that it was always a question on the AP history exam, but it was not. I'd also like to thank my family and the faculty who have been so supportive. Something that all my teachers provided and an overall impression I received from Belvidere was the motivation to push myself to be better. I think the greatest lesson we can take from our time at Belvidere is to take advantage of our opportunities. It is something ingrained into us since freshman orientation, but I believe that the majority of us have followed through and experienced the benefits. For those of you who started out school with a fall sport, you may remember how wonderful it was to be able to make friends you'll see in classes and form connections with your coaches. Once entering high school, we were greeted with the option of joining loads of clubs, extracurriculars, and more sports teams. This is how we learn our likes and dislikes, passions, and interests. Through these pursuits, we learn more about ourselves. And for those of you who pushed yourselves by taking advanced placement or honors classes, continue to do so in college, because there comes a point where effort surpasses talent. Finally, take advantage of your opportunities so you can make irreplaceable memories. Whether it's the time we won the spirit stick, snowball, prom, homecoming, or moments with friends and teachers, I'm sure there's at least one fond memory that stands out to you. When I started out as a freshman, I was uncertain at what to expect. However, I was met with individuals who were kind, smart, creative, athletic, determined, and made Belvidere feel like a second home. Throughout the years, it became apparent that the class of 2019 was also immensely talented. From athletics, to Freddie nomination-worthy musicals, to choir, to academic endeavors. You have all made memories for me. And with this show of ambition and character, I know that it is inevitable that you will all make meaningful memories in the future. As much as many of us may be excited to leave Belvidere, the truth is that this is it for high school. There is no reliving or redoing. That is why it's even more imperative to look forward. Some of us are going to college, the military, trade schools, and others decided on a different path. But opportunities still exist if you look for them. I personally do not know exactly what kind of person I will be in 20 years' time. But our choices allow us to determine what type of person we will strive to become. So I would like to leave you all with this final image. If everyone was a runner and we all ran at the same time, there'd be different paces. Some would run slow, fast, and along the way, people would take different paths. However, in life, some opportunities require racing, It takes ignoring the buildup of lactic acid and overcoming the feeling of not being able to do it anymore. My point is that even if something requires hard work, perseverance, some blood, sweat, and tears, as long as there's something worth it at the end of the finish line, I encourage you to go for it. Thank you and congratulations, class of 2019.
Desley, take your...
Thank you, Desley.
Thank you, Desley. All right. At this time, we'll have a musical selection by the BH Chamber Choir. Thank you, guys. This year, our Teacher of the Year at the high school, Deb Cope,
has also been selected as the Warren County Teacher of the Year. It is a great honor, and we believe this is the first time a Belvidere teacher has received this honor. Now, technically, she does not assume that title in September, so we'll just keep that between us. That'll be our little secret. But at this time, I'd like to introduce and bring up to the podium our reigning Warren County Teacher of the Year, Deborah Ruth Koch.
Good evening. 2 weeks ago, I had the honor of representing Belvidere High School and Warren County at the NJEA for media training. One of the goals for the day was to record a video interview with each county representative. At about the third question into my interview, the interview asked me, "Why do you love what you teach?" And I hesitated. Then I explained to her that I don't love my subject matter as much as I love my overall job. I am so lucky that I am afforded the opportunity to work with students every day. And more importantly, I love that I get to build lasting relationships with my students, in part because I have coffee and food, but more importantly, because I'm lucky enough to have many of you in class for 4 years. Unlike most grade level teachers, I have seen this class come in as somewhat awkward, unsure, and a little bit wild freshmen, and watched you blossom into the kind, beautiful, considerate, and mature young adults that are sitting in front of us today. I wholeheartedly mean it when I say it is a great honor to be able to address this class of 2019. Most of you have been ready for change since the start of the third marking period. But today, you sit here. Many of you are nervous. Some of you are nostalgic. Others of you are scared about that change that will happen once you turn your tassel to the other side. And some of you are questioning, am I really ready? I'm here to assure you that you are ready. If you've had me in class, you know that as the bell rings at the end of each class period, I usually yell, "Be safe, make good choices, spread the love," or any combination of such. Now, as you are leaving, I feel like I should offer some additional advice. So here it is. Never stop exploring. Whether it be on country roads or in a big city, look at every sight, inhale the smells, listen to every sound, take it all in and appreciate the beauty of the world around us. Find a passion so great that you forget to check your cell phones. Work hard, because nothing worth having comes easy. Don't be afraid to change your mind. If you don't like your job, your major, your friends, your relationship, your direction, change it. When things look bleak, look through a different lens. Admit when you were wrong, say you were sorry and mean it, and honor your commitments. Be brave enough to ask for help when you need it, and save your pennies for when times are tough. Be gentle with the demands that you make on yourself, and give second chances, but not thirds. Be kind, even when someone is unkind to you. Go out into the world and see and do everything you dream of, then come back to Belvidere when you are ready to settle down and maybe even raise families of your own. And when you look back, I hope you remember these gifts that you have been given. A school full of staff who consider all of you our children. A community who comes out to support our students. And there's no greater example of that than that big fire truck over there raising the flag.
You were stuck.
You've been given the opportunity to be stakeholders in your community through working with projects like the Community Lunch and the Belvidere Community Center. You've been given the ability to play sports and be active in clubs simultaneously. The opportunity to be mentors and role models to middle school and elementary school students. And most importantly, the gift that we take it for granted the most, you have been given the gift of a safe public education. We are so proud of all of you, and look forward to hearing about your next adventures. This class is not just part of Belvidere High School's history. You are part of our family, and even though you will no longer linger in our halls, you will linger in our hearts. Together, we are all Belvidere. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Koch. Mr. McInerney, Board of Education, I hereby certify that the students seated before you have satisfactorily completed all the requirements for graduation as prescribed by the Belvidere Board of Education and have met all the requirements of the State of New Jersey Department of Education. Therefore, without any reservations whatsoever, I recommend these students be awarded their diplomas on this day, the 14th day of June 2019. Mr. McInerney, it is my privilege to present to you the Belvidere High School Class of 2019. Ms. McKinney.
Christopher J. Allen. Brennan Michael Anderson. Shadiman Anderson. Doriana Auletta. Liam Ayers. Ryan Joseph Baxter. Elisa M. Beers. Shelby Vier. Cole Bienis. Jacob R. Billick. Anthony Richard Bacchino. Nicholas Angelo Bacchino. Ryan Bonamo. Abby Rose Bronico. Jillian Winter Burkhard. Madeline Marie Call. Joseph Casterline. Melanie Elizabeth Clark. Alexis Ann Connors. Allison K. Dysonroth. Heather A. DiLorenzo. Dennis J. Dornich, Jr. Samantha Lynn Dultz. Matthew Walter Dene. Hannah Rose Enslin. Logan Christopher Fazio. Christopher Fiore. Jared Galicki. Gage Garris. Christopher R. Grafer. Patrick J. Gulix. Noel Han. Miranda Elise Hannon. Teresa M. Hannon. Megan Lee Hausman. Erica Hobart. Jessica Joan Hothouse. Juliana Marie Hothouse. Bailey S. Kaza. Mallory Keenan. Alan W. Kiley. Domenick J. Lepore. Samantha Alyssa Lavodi. Anya May Logan. Edward Laura Jr. Alexandria R. Lorenzo. Merrick A. Loyal. Christopher A. Magrini. Taylor Lynn McKenna. Christopher I. McLean. Quinn T. Malofchik. Bailey Owen Mitchell. G. Molion. Lindsay T. Montalone. Devin M. Mullen. Samuel W. Meyerchen. Idelia Marie Natal. Vasilios K. Nikolopoulos. Mason J. Oaks. Francesca Genia Palmisano. Levi Pinella. Monique Nicole Panetta. Isabella Maria Pedraza. Maggie Elizabeth Pernini. Seth Preston Peel. Cameron Lynn Popiak. Tony Marie Popiak. Theo Alexander Prospero. Jacqueline E. Richardson. Elijah Zaire Roberts. Vanessa Rodriguez. Angelina Grace Rodriguez. Darren Rush. Nicholas J. Santini. Amanda R. Santoro. Carmen Zofia Sarwinski. Alexander Joseph Scherzinger. Robert J. Schnesler. Casey P. Senna. Ashley Madison Sendzikowski. Kimberly Silva. Tyler Robert Smith. Garrett Michael Snook. Joshua David Snook. Yeah. Gina Victoria Spagnuolo. Jason Andrew Thompson. Michael A. Tingoli, Jr. Kira Tompkins. Lauren D. Tordick. Ezra J. Torres. Timothy P. Toth. Maria Rosina Turker. Louis S. Turner. Christian T. Van Scoten. Ryan V. Vey. Alexa Christine Verkylen. Hunter Webb. John W. Wyckoff. Devin Matthew Yowie. Luke D. Youngman. Wyatt M. Zara. Kayla Zorn. Haley Elizabeth Biasco. Matthew Lee Bronico. Desley L. Norcross. Jordan R. Corey. Brett Daniel Dalrymple. Morgan E. Carroll. Tiffany J. Path. Francis Joseph Vandevigate. Emma Kate Beanie. Angelina Julia Santini. Olivia Ann Swanson.
We're now going to do the tassel ritual.
Good job.
Everybody stand for the alma mater. Ready? You take it. The peak question. The Delaware. Oh, shit. Stands the school. Tis fair Belvidere. Dear old high school, how we love her. Long may she endure. Hail to thee, our alma mater. Hail to Belvidere. As the fleeting years go by, may she stronger grow. Only honor and glory shall she ever know. Dear old high school, how we love her. Long may she endure.
That was a good shot.
Thank you.
That was a great way to follow it, Kevin.